Good afternoon, students. Today, let us learn about the animal tissue. There are mainly four kinds of animal tissues are there. That are epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue, and neural tissue. Then, we know that the epithelial tissue, that is covering the body surface as well as many organs are covered by the epithelial tissue, and it also the internal part of the blood vessels or the organs etc. are covered by the epithelial cells. Here you can see its location. Here it covers the surface of the body, then lines various body cavities inside the stomach or inside the heart etc. are covered by the epithelial cell. The outermost layer of the skin and lining surface of the mouth, nose, lungs, stomach etc. are also the epithelial tissue we can find. Then the shape is given there. Three kinds of shapes we can see in the epithelial tissue, that are flat, cuboidal or columnar shape. Columnar meaning column shape, like the pillar shape we can see the epithelial cells. Then many functions are done by the epithelial tissue. Their main function is the protection, as our skin is protecting our body. Then absorption, in the intestine their epithelial cells are absorbing the nutrients. Then the secretion, in intestine some cells are secreting the epithelial cells. In inside our ear also, the ear wax is the secretion of the epithelial cells. Then here, then again sensory perceptions. Epithelial cells of our tongue or nose, that is catching the sensations, smell, taste etc. are also perceived by the epithelial cell. So different functions are done by the epithelial cells. Then the first category of epithelial cells are squamous epithelium, that is flat and thin shaped are the squamous epithelium. For example, where the squamous epithelial cells are found, they are found in the lining of the mouth or nasal cavities or blood vessels etc. and lymph vessels etc. are made up of, their epithelial cells are squamous epithelial cell. They are scale like shape, thin and flat, and they have a prominent, a clear nucleus also present in the squamous epithelial cell. Then its functions are also, it protect the underlying part from the mechanical injury or from the entry of germs or from the chemicals, and also it prevent the evaporation of water. It protect from drying up are the functions of squamous epithelial cells. Then stratified epithelium, that is found in the skin and cornea, the stratified epithelial cells are found. Here the picture of the stratified epithelium. Several layers of cells are there. In our skin we know that many layers, after 2 or 3 days several layers, maybe dead cells may be removed from the surface of our skin. We learned that because our skin is made up of this stratified epithelial cell, new cells may be produced from the lower side. That is the stratified epithelial cells. Many layers are present, that is stratified epithelium. Then cuboid epithelial cell. Here you can see the cuboidal, the picture of the cuboid epithelium is found here. Usually this cuboidal epithelial cells are found in the kidney tubule. They are certain secretions are produced by the cuboidal epithelial cell. They have glandular ducts and salivary glands in pancreatic duct. These cuboidal epithelial cells are found. Then again, the columnar epithelium, column shaped or its shape is columnar epithelium, like the pillar shaped. It has a nucleus and its shape is column shape. So they are known as columnar epithelial cells. They are vertically arranged brick like cell. Then it is found in the inner lining of stomach and intestine. They may be secrete something or such cells are found in the intestinal wall, inside the stomach, etc. We can see the columnar epithelium. Then again, columnar epithelium containing the ciliated columnar epithelium. Usually the ciliated columnar epithelium found in the trachea. We know that it is secreting the mucus, so that dust particles may be trapped inside the secretions by the ciliated columnar epithelium, and it is it has also a cilia or small hair like structures are found in the ciliated epithelium. It has column shaped columnar ciliated epithelium. It has column shape as well as it has cilia at one end. The cilia will, by its particular movement, it will direct the dust particle that is entering into the trachea or windpipe that to our throat, so we can spit it out. So ciliated epithelium, columnar ciliated epithelium. Then another epithelial cells are glandular epithelium. Here such cells are found in the lining of the stomach. Lining of the stomach, the ciliated ciliated columnar glandular epithelial cells are found in the lining of the stomach. Then they also found in the sweat glands or tear or liver cells. Glandular epithelial cells are there, so it can secrete its secretions from the liver. We know that it is bile is produced by the liver. Tear gland produce tear. Then sweat glands produce sweat. They are produced by the glandular epithelial cell. So we learned about the epithelial cells. Then the next type of cells are connective tissue. We epithelial tissue we learned. Then the next one is connective tissue. That is connecting different organs or parts of the body. Connective tissue bind the tissues. It is connecting various organ, or it will help to communicate with the other parts of the body. Then its peculiarity, its characteristics are given there. Abundance of intercellular spaces are there in connective tissue. Many intercellular space, a lot of intercellular space is there. Then fewer cellular elements and fibers also. In some connective tissue, it contains certain fiber, elastic fiber like structures are also found in the connective tissue. Here three kinds of connective tissues are given. One is connective tissue proper, that serve for the packing and binding of organs. We know that we have heart, intestine, lungs, etc. are there. All the organs are in its proper place. Without moving away from its place, it is properly bind there by the connective tissue proper. Then supportive connective tissue, it gives strength and support to our body. That are supportive connective tissue. Cartilages and bones are example. We know that the bones are giving strength to our body. Cartilages is giving support, that the cartilage is present in our nose or in the ears, that giving its shape to that organ. Cartilage is present inside the nose and in the external ear. we know that the pinna of the ear, the outside part of the ear, also containing the supportive connective tissue. Then fluid connective tissue, we know that the fluid connective tissue include the blood and the lymph, include the fluid connective tissue. Then here certain pictures of the connective tissues are there. Areolar or packing tissues, that is found occurring beneath the epidermis of the skin. You know that it maintain the elasticity of the skin. Here you can see the picture. If we pull our skin, that will that may be elastic, that take the previous shape. When we release that pinch, that take the previous shape that came to that, because of its elasticity the skin can maintain its particular structure. So areolar connective tissue, that is beneath the epidermis of the skin, and it make the skin elastic and help to withstand the pulling strain. Then adipose tissue, we know that adipose meaning fat. So there are fat tissues are present, that may be in many parts of our body. Sometimes it may be under the skin. Adipose tissue, fat tissues may be under the skin, or sometimes around the internal organ, around the kidneys or heart, or beneath the eyeball, around the eyeball, etc. Adipose or fat tissues may be present. Then another connective tissue is fibrous connective tissue. Picture of the fibrous connective tissue is there. It has a lot of matrix is there at our intercellular space. You can see the nucleus and cells that are with a lot of intercellular space between the cell. Then another structures are also there, fibers are there, elastic fibers are also there. They are fibrous connective tissue. They are found in the tendons. We know that tendons are the particular kind of tissue that is connecting a muscle to a bone. Tendons and ligaments in between the vertebrae, in such places it is connecting a bone to another bone, or to bone to a muscle. Such fibrous connective tissues are found in our body. So the connective tissue proper containing areolar, adipose and fibrous connective tissue. Then again the supportive connective tissue, that is giving a support to our body. Cartilage, we know that our nostrils, around our nostrils, the nose, it is supported by the cartilage, as well as our external ear, known as the pinna of the ear. External ear, it has also cartilage. Certain speciality is there for the cartilage. Then it is a lot of intercellular spaces is there. Then it is non-porous. There is no space or pores in this cell. Then again it is semi-transparent. Transparent meaning it can allow light. If we pass the torch light or light through our ear pinna, that is semi-transparent. Because of it, the cartilage is semi-transparent, we can pass the light through. If we can light a torch light, or if we can pass the light through that ear pinna, it is semi-transparent and elastic. Cartilage is elastic. If we fold our ear pinna, that will again return to its position, because it is elastic. So that are the peculiarity of cartilage. Then again the bone tissue, that is porous. Here the cartilage and the structure of the cartilage. Here also a lot of intercellular space in the cartilage. Cartilage, you can see lot of intercellular space is there and a matrix is there. Then here the bone tissue, it is porous. Here have Havasian canal, you can see it is the pores through which the blood vessels or the nerves are coming into the bones. Then again you can see the bone cell. It has cytoplasmic extensions, so several thread like structures you can see them in the bone cell, that are many cytoplasmic extensions in the bone cell. Then the bone cells are arranged around that canal like in a concentric lamellae. You can see it is placed in a concentric manner. The bone cells are placed and there are pores in it. In the bone tissue there are pores. Through that pores the blood vessels and the nerves are coming and entering or passing through the bone. Then its bone cells have a particular name known as osteoblast. The bone cells are known as osteoblast. Then the bone also has another structure. They containing many inorganic salts are present in the bone. Inorganic salt, we know that a lot of calcium or phosphorus etc. present in the bone cell. Many salt, inorganic salts are deposited in between the bone cell. A lot of inorganic salts are deposited. Then the another kind of tissue is the fluid connective tissue. We know that blood and lymph are the two fluid connective tissue. Blood containing the liquid part known as the plasma, and it also containing red blood cell, white blood cell and platelets. You all learned it in 8th standard in detail about the blood. The lymph is the fluid that is surrounding the body cell. It is then collected by the lymph vessels and is transported through the lymph vessel, and later it is connected to the blood. You all learned about how the lymph vessels are joining the blood vessels. You learned it in the 8th standard. Then the main function of the lymph is the transportation of fat or certain minerals, as well as it is containing the lymphocytes, that are the blood vessels that is protecting or fighting against the germs. So it is protecting the against diseases. That are the functions of the fluid connective tissue. Blood, you know that the red blood cells are transporting oxygen and carrying out carbon dioxide from the cell. Transportation of oxygen is connecting different parts of the body. All the parts are connected by the blood. Blood is taking out the waste as well as giving nutrients to the cell. All these functions are done by the blood and the lymph. They are fluid connective tissue. Then we have to learn about the muscle tissue. Then there are three kinds of muscles are there: striated, unstriated and heart muscle or cardiac muscle. You can see the striated muscles. They are voluntary muscles. We can move these muscles according to our will, that is attached to our skeleton. These striated muscles are attached to our skeleton. We can move it according to our will. It has certain stripes on it, so it is known as striated muscle, because we can move it according to our will, so that it is also known as voluntary muscle. Then unstriated muscle. These are unstriated muscle. They are involuntary muscle. They are found usually in some parts like our intestine that are moving not according to our will. Intestine, then iris of the eye or in the skin, then lining of blood vessels, urinary bladder, uterus, etc. These are the parts not move according to our will. Unstriated muscles are found in these places that are in skin, blood vessels, urinary bladder, etc. That are the part that are not move according to our will. Striated muscle, unstriated muscle. Then the third type is the cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscles are found in heart. That is also involuntary. Then cardiac muscle has certain speciality. They are branched like. It has a branched type of muscle. Cell has several branch like structures are there. So it is found only in heart. Then cardiac muscles are striated. Again, uninucleated and branched is particular about the cardiac muscle. That also involuntary muscle, so we cannot move it according to our will. Then the last kind of tissue is the neural tissue that are found in the nervous system, in our brain and spinal cord or in all our nerves. This neural tissues we can see. Neural tissue, it has a particular part, perikaryon or cyton, its cell body. It has a cell body and a long axon is there. A long strand axon is present and axon endings you can see. Then from the cell body, many dendrons are branched structures known as dendrons are present. Then dendron again divided into dendrites. Then this is the structure of the neural or nervous tissue, neural cells or nervous tissue. Then again it is covered by particular structure known as myelin sheath is there. Myelin sheath and node of Ranvier, certain structures constricted part known as node of Ranvier. Then certain particular neurolemma is the cells that are covering the axon. So this is the structure of the nervous tissue. We know that the dendrons will carry impulses from the cell and pass these impulses through the axon. So it has they are the longest cells in human body and it carry messages to the brain, and from the brain it carry the message to the glands and organs. Today I am finishing the lesson and I shall send some notes also after this. Thank you.